Good afternoon, WFYI Facebook fans. Jill Ditmire here with you. We are at the Indiana History Center this afternoon. They're actually having a VIP reception because today is the opening of an exhibit that's going to be up for the next month or so. It's all about the LGBT experiences in Indiana. It's called Be Heard. And this is a really exceptional collection of stories and photographs of people from all over the state of Indiana. And you can see when you come upstairs to the second floor here at the History Center, you can tour the area and read and hear about people from all ages and all communities of Indiana. And Suzanne Hahn is one of the curators here at the History Center. And tell me why you guys decided to start this collection and then make it one of your prime exhibits for the next month.
Sure. Well, our mission is to be Indiana storyteller, and so we're constantly looking at our library collection to make sure that our stories are telling the stories for all Hoosiers. And so we started the LGBT Collecting Initiative in 2014, focusing on collecting photographs and documents and publications and oral histories. Oral histories have certainly been a big part of the collecting initiative. We've captured so many great stories, and so we wanted a chance to exhibit and kind of tell all these wonderful stories.
We'll let Scott give you just a little bit of a look here. Did you, when you put out the call, were you surprised at how many people responded, or did you have a hard time finding things?
You know, we have been so surprised and so thankful because people have donated this material to us. And so they've been very generous with their resources and their time, especially with the oral history. So it's been very positive.
It's also a great representation. You have all ages and people from all different times of experiencing what it's like to be in the LGBT community in Indiana as it has changed throughout the decades.
Sure. Sure. And that was certainly a goal. We wanted to cover all areas of the state and all backgrounds. So I think we certainly accomplished that.
And obviously you want to stimulate some conversations here with us as well, I'm guessing.
We do. I mean, that's the purpose of all of our exhibits, is to start that dialogue and have those conversations. So again, I think this is such a great exhibit and such a great way to share the stories we've captured.
Speaking of sharing the stories, this exhibit features a lot of oral histories. You know, every time you come down here, you have the You Are There experiences here in the museum, where a lot of times they have actors that are portraying the real people, but with this exhibit, you get to hear from the real people, and that was Mark Lee's job, was to collect these oral histories. And my oh my, you have a wonderful selection here.
Thank you very much.
How did you reach out and get the stories? Did you actually interview everybody?
Yes, I conducted all the interviews. Several of the people I knew, but then a lot of it was just like reaching out to friends on Facebook, just trying to figure out, you know, like who would have a good story to tell, and then, you know, like, or as I'm interviewing somebody that maybe I didn't know, they would say, hey, have you talked to so-and-so yet? So, you know, it just kind of snowballs that way, and just trying to talk to the widest variety of people that we possibly could.
Yeah, I would think, as Suzanne said, there was just a great response to this. How did you narrow it down to who makes the wall and who doesn't?
For the wall, we were really trying to get just the most diverse group of people that we possibly could with the most compelling stories. So, you know, just as I was just thinking through, just saying like for example, Kimberly Acuff just had a really compelling story to tell as she's being interviewed. And so she was one of the first people who came to my mind. But just, you know, just, and it was difficult trying to narrow it down, but we tried to get, you know, like different age ranges, ethnicities, everything. So just, yeah.
And this is what you do. So when you come up, you pick up the phone here, and
And you can hear.
Yes,
you can
hear
people telling the
A
story.
Or B and hear their story.
Select your story, whichever that you want. Were any of the stories super surprising to you as one of the collectors? Anything just really still, I mean, they're all, they're very personal stories, but anything just really stick out in your mind from the people that you interviewed?
Jacqueline Patterson, who's not one of the people that we, put on display here this week, but I interviewed her with her wife, and just the interview itself was kind of like a therapy session, but it was basically the first time they spoke since her transition. And they, it surprised me that they got married. And it wasn't until after they got married that Jacqueline started the transition process. And it wasn't until after she was on hormones that she decided she should probably tell her wife that this is what she's doing. So they had a lot to talk about as far as, you know, trying to make that work for their marriage and move on from there. But yeah, that was very surprising for me.
And because you did interview people of all ages that have been experiencing this at all different times in the state of the history, did they all still kind of have like one message, just to be loved and be accepted?
Pretty much, yeah. Just that. The message was love and acceptance, and just trying to find their own way in society.
It's a powerful exhibit, and it's going to be up through November, so you can come down here to the History Center and take a peek. And like I said, tonight they're having a nice VIP reception. Some of the people that took part in the exhibit are here, and everybody else is just getting ready for Indiana to reach out and be educated once again, as it always is here at the History Center. And we'll see you guys again next week on the WFYI Facebook page.